more on the marketing side rather than the on the side of technicality.
Yeah.
And that gave me a big kick. And I started myself establishing as a marketing strategist.
Okay.
So those years, like 2002 to 2007, I took a lot of tough years for me to establish myself as a marketing strategist.
Mm-hmm.
And later on, I started giving a lot of consultancy on segment marketing.
Yeah.
So segment marketing was my key to success for every people whomsoever I've consulted.
Yes.
And
yes.
they have actually grown their business into 5x, 10x, and multifolds. Right. Because mm-hmm. segment marketing, you can define a lot of segments in terms of geographic, demographics.
Yes.
Product gaps. Because yes. in industry, there are a lot of potential competitors. But if you need to compete with them, mm-hmm. you need to have a pricing strategy, a type of a typical product gap.
Yeah.
As need to have a lot of penetration work through geographical, demographic segmentization.
Yeah, right.
Mm-hmm. So that gives me a kick to grow myself in as a marketing strategist. And after 2007 to 2011,
yeah,
we got a big project with Prince Plastics,
yeah.
and that was my big hit in terms of. Growing as a management consultant, because
yes.
what I found is marketing strategy is a very small bit in a consulting zone.
Mm-hmm.
And above the all gurus, like if you must have seen a lot of gods in Hindu mythology.
Yeah. Yeah.
So Shiva is being as the one of the biggest in the in all the gods.
Yes.
When I found that, you know, like management is the main key to success.
Okay.
If you can manage it, everything in a right way, right method.
Yeah.
A lot of negative thing you can convert into positive. But right. it has to be in a right mechanism to grow.
Yeah.
And it has a strategy behind. It has to have a micro goals mm-hmm. and a lot of potential to grow an organization from one layer to another layer.
Mm-hmm.
So 2007 right. was the year where I cracked the deal with a very big giant, and I took 180 CR turnover company to around 460 CR by around 4.5 years time.
Wow, nice.
And I got a very big exposure there because I couldn't manage a lot of areas of, you can say, like a lot of areas into different departments.
Yes.
This organization, because all the departments are the body parts of the organization. Any of the department is not working, the organization will always be handicapped.
Yeah, right.
And they cannot grow that in another way.
Okay.
So that's how it took me. And okay. 2011 to 2016 was my peak. It was like my golden years, I can say.
Yeah.
I have actually explored so many industries. Like I worked with around 85 different industries and more than 100 plus clients.
Mm-hmm.
And in my career, I have actually generated revenue.
Yeah.
So wherever I smell business, I smell money. It's called revenue. The
mm-hmm.
growth in the revenue sector, because revenue is where the main key comes from. Main
yeah.
key come from any owner to work harder, smarter.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And when the revenue start growing, mm-hmm. automatically they forget to look after the net profits. This is
yeah.
where the major crisis starts in any organization when they are growing.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And at the same time, they forget to create a kind of a reserve funds and the as well as the corpus funds.
Mm-hmm.
So today, when you see this this pandemic, which has been now it's actually killing a lot of businesses.
Yes.
But those who will survive, who has already developed some of the funds in terms of corpus or reserves.
Yeah, yeah.
So lately I was talking to one of my clients and he is having around 218 employees.
Okay.
And he was like, Jigar, it was great that you guided me to have a corpus or a reserve
mm-hmm.
in my back years.
Yeah.
And I'm actually surviving and I have a 3 months corpus so that after the lockdown, I'll
yes.
be able to take the risk of surviving after the lockdown.
Yes.
Because that will be the biggest hit in this negative area, because negative, like as today's topic, which we have been encountering, is like negative is a new positive.
Right, right.
Why the new green is negative? Because, you know, Bharat, if you must have seen in the past, there are a lot of difficult times have come to a lot of businesses.
Yes.
So I consider businesses and their industry is like a big ocean.
Yeah.
So it is your journey, how you swim in that big ocean.
Mm-hmm.
And in ocean, sometimes storm comes, sometimes it is low tide, high tide.
Yeah.
You get carried away with the bad current of waves.
Yes.
So same way, this type of turmoil always come in a lot of businesses.
That's right.
So this pandemic is one type of turmoil. But mm-hmm. I think people should not to worry about it.
Yeah.
Because people take worrying about negativity, like what will happen next, what will go wrong, how it will mm-hmm. go wrong. It doesn't matter, because
yes.
as day by day this lockdown will open, and after lockdown the day by day will be like going on and on.
Yeah.
Automatically people will able to understand a lot of dynamics. So they need to reinvent, reimagine, redefine lot of stuff.
Right.
In terms of running their business from mm-hmm. the scratch. It will be like even though they have established from a lot of years, but still they will feel that, you know, we have to start it through the scratch.
Right.
So
right.
My key suggestion to all these people is very simple.
Mm.
They will be like worrying about it. So better make a 90 days plan before this lockdown gets over. And after lockdown, only work with that 90 days plan. So what this plan should be like, how it, mm-hmm. what are the pointers we need to cover in this 90 days plan.
Yeah.
So it is like very simple. We need to cover a lot of stuff. It starts from the pending stuff. So which are those pending stuff which you need to clear it off? Like taxation is the most important mm-hmm. pending stuff.
Hmm.
So if you can talk to your CAs, and if you can hold those cash by not moving out of your pockets, you should have certain amount of time which is given by government to pay it back. And they are also have rebated in terms of interest on the taxation. So that is also a very good sign from government.
Yeah.
The second thing which I am actually looking thing is the cash flow management.
Mm-hmm.
People don't understand why the cash flow is so important.
Mm-hmm.
So the cash flow should be 1:3 ratio. Like people will think what is 1 and what is 3.
Yes.
So 1 is your outgoing and 3 is inflow.
Yes.
So people has to start regenerating 1:3 ratio, because if they work on that 1:3 ratio, to survive this 90 days after the lockdown, and automatically the positive sign from this negative will be given up.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And it will grow like anything.
Yes.
And apart from this, the third pointer which I always tell people is about marketing. So mm-hmm. go to your survival segments.
Yeah.
Because people will not have a want-based market after mm-hmm. the lockdown. It will be a need-based market.
Yes.
Because nobody will go and buy an iPhone immediately.
Yes.
Right. There will be a lot of need-based markets.
So, yeah.
So those people who are always focusing on profits, it will be very difficult for them to get a big market immediately after the 90 days after the lockdown.
Mm-hmm.
So
right.
So they need to focus on the primary things like survival segments.
Mm-hmm.
Might be service,
might
be AMC segments. So write down from deliverables of the survival segment, they need to set small micro goals that by this week, I will able to achieve at least this much number in my survival segment.
Yes.
So that much marketing efforts they need to put.
Mm. Great. There are a lot of fans. Jigar, there are a lot of fans of yours. Pooja Seth is saying, hello, sir.
Yeah, she is my one of my, you can say my a very good employee, and she used to work with me from past 3.5 years. I have taught her a lot of stuff. Hi Pooja, how are you? And nice to see you online.
You got a great friend, Manoj Danwani, is saying hello to you.
Hi Manoj.
And you got Tejal also saying hello.
Hi Tejal.
Tejal Shah is there, who's saying
Tejal
hello to
Shah
you.
Shah is my sister.
Okay. And Neeraj Jagarwal is saying, good to see both of the business coaches on single frame. So,
thanks, Neeraj. Thanks.
And Tejal Fadke is also saying, wow, great moments of yours. And Viren Mehta is saying, hello, Jigar.
Yeah, he's my very good father's friend.
Yeah, and got Tejra Singh saying, hello, Jigar.
Hi, Tej. How are you?
And Karan Soni is there.
Yeah, he's my one of my startup clients. Karan Soni.
Great. Suresh Notani says, hello, Jigar.
Hi, Suresh.
Himangi is there. She's saying, hello, Jigar and Bharat.
Hi, Himangi, and apologies for yesterday.
And you got Dispal Sakaria saying, hello.
Also one of my clients on board right now.
You got Rajesh Mutreja saying, hello.
Yeah. Hi, Rajesh.
And then Nitesh Mutreja also saying, hi, Jigar.
Hi, Nitesh.
And then you got Ramandeep Kaur saying great insights about you, about the business you're saying right now.
Hi, Raman. Raman is Ramandeep Kaur. My dear friend from Delhi.
Okay.
So they are actually a support system, online support system. We have met on Facebook and she's also one of a very good life coach in Delhi.
Okay, yeah. Great. And they got Shyam Sharma saying, Sarji, namaste. I mean, it's a indefinite group of wishes coming to you. Rajesh Kumar says hello.
Yeah, thank you.
Arth is saying Jigar and Bharat, deadly combination. No. Okay, Sandeep Dixit says two smart guys. Okay, great. Shivesh Agarwal from Hyderabad says hello to you. And you got Rasika Palekar saying hello.
Thank you. Wow.
Sandeep Dixit says hello to you. Great. Thanks. So Hemangi says, no problem, Jigar. I love 1:3 formula. We'll work on this. So you already got some input coming.
Thank you.
So what you are saying is right, rethink, reimagine, re-evaluate and redefining the business post COVID-19. So look at some of the businesses who must be suffering a lot of losses today, huge losses, due to zero sales and continuous fixed expenses like rentals, salaries to staff, etc. Now, once lockdown is lifted, what steps can we take in order to control cost, minimize expenses also?
It is very simple, Bharat, because you understand we cannot minimize the cost.
Yes.
So if you understand, it will be always a need-based market after lockdown, like 90 days.
Yeah.
So we also need to minimize our cost only on the need-based thing. Because if we will minimize everything on a need base, so automatically your cost will also go down on a need-based part. So if you have certain fixed expenses, you need to renegotiate, you need to re-evaluate with them and take a time for at least a 3 line so that all those costs can be redefined in your in your business expenses. So once you do that, automatically the smooth line of the expenses goes down.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
You got more wishes coming in. Naresh Patare saying hi to you.
Hi, Naresh.
And Mrugang Dixit is saying hi to you.
Hi.
And then there's Shruti, friend of mine, saying hello, Bharat. Amrita Singh saying hi.
Hi.
And Manisha Kamble saying hi, Jigar.
Hi, Manisha.
Mahin Sukhija, he's saying hello, Mr. Jigar Shah.
Oh, how are you, Mahin?
And there's one great friend of yours, Revan Datta, saying, hi, Jigar Babu, you are an amazing coach.
Oh, thank you, Revan.
And Ankit Sukleja, Jigar sir, you rock.
Oh, thank you, Ankit.
So wishes are coming in, almost 64 comments on your Facebook Live. Sonali Chawla says, would love to learn more business strategies from you. Hope you know Sonali Chawla.
Oh, she is also a very good marketing person.
Yeah.
So, marketing and sales.
Connect with her tomorrow.
Yeah.
Sonali Shah says, hi, dear.
Sonali Shah is my wife.
Wow, so great.
Thanks, Sonali, to support.
We got Rajan Nambiar saying, hi, Jigar, waiting to listen more from you. How the marketing will go with social distancing?
Yeah. So, Rajan, I'll introduce. Rajan Nambiar is my very good dear friend.
Okay.
And where I have consulted this organization called Nirvana.
Okay.
To a very good modular furniture manufacturing in Vasai.
Okay, great.
And this company, I have worked with them in 2015, and I achieved a milestone by setting their sales within 6 months, 1.5 CR within 6 months.
Nice.
Today they are doing more, and Rajan Nambiar right now is the marketing head.
There. Okay, great.
So thanks, Rajan, to be there. Thank you so much, Rajan.
And Nidhi Singh is there. Hi, Jigar. It's always great to follow your guidance.
Thank you, Nidhi.
Vatsala Rao says, hi, Jigar. Glad to have joined in. Very insightful.
Thanks so much, Vatsala.
Ankit Sukleja, to both, sir, what do you think about fitness industry and its business?
Yes, fitness is the one of the toppest industry will flourish within next 3 years.
Yes.
If you must have seen, there are a lot of people who has now gone to a sattvic diet.
Mm-hmm.
So after the lockdown period, once the government will leave the permission of gym and health centers,
yeah,
there will be a lot of growth in the nutrients, health and wellness part, and it will be a next era they can see in their industry, which I can see.
Right.
It will be an all-time high in the fitness.
Yeah. Yes. And Nidhi Singh is saying, I remember you taught me Kotler in no time.
Oh, thank you, Nidhi. Thank you.
Okay, Venkat Raman Iyer says, hello, Jigar, to you.
Hello, Venkat ji.
So, tell me, Jigar, what kind of businesses or industries you think are going to suffer the most, and which industries offer new opportunities?
Okay. Stop. This industries, because if you must have seen, auto and auto components will suffer very badly.
Yeah.
Aviation and tourism will suffer very badly. Building, yes, and construction will be suffered very badly.
Mm-hmm.
Apparels and textile, metals and mining and oil and gas. Mm-hmm. These are the major areas were growing and booming. But now, because of this negative as a new positive,
yeah.
So if you must have seen, this all is want-based market. And when this industry will start suffering, it will in other industries too, because these are the major key industries, which actually you can say is the movers and shakers of a lot of economic industry.
Mm-hmm.
So it always have to... It has have a cycle of 5 years, but I can't see them suffering for 5 years. But yeah, it will suffer for more than 1.5 year more.
Mm-hmm.
And then it will gradually slow down the suffering, and then it will start picking up very fast. Because when there will be a change from need to want based market, automatically this demands will start booming.
Yeah.
Then it will have a balance in the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
And the company will flourish is financial services will flourish very good, because if you must have seen banking and NBFCs,
yeah,
their demand will increase because people need funds after this. There'll be a lot of small, medium, large organizations will need funds.
Mm-hmm.
And this industry, they will be working on a war front, because if they will not work on the war front, there will be a lot of issues. Like if you must have seen, RBI has also have given a lot of caps, funds, or you can say a lot of caps on this industry. So financial services will boom like anything.
Okay.
Then consumer retail, consumer and retail segment will also boom for hotel and restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you see consumer, those who are actually awaiting to have their desired products, they will actually go and buy it after the lockdown.
Yes.
And chemical and petroleum industry will grow automatically, because there will be a lot of shift in the pharmaceuticals as well as so the chemical and petroleum is the key raw material product industry for pharmaceuticals.
Okay.
So when this two industry, major industry will boom, automatically pharmaceutical has to boom.
Yeah, right.
Then food and agriculture industry will boom.
Mm-hmm.
Then you can say transport and logistic will boom. And the most important, which I see right now, it's a very, very sheer thing, very, very thin line between internet industry and the digital content industry.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you must have seen that a lot of people now, they are fed up looking into a digital content. They have actually stuck very badly mentally that there is no new content on the digital platform.
Right.
So this will be the rise of this industry, the digital content industry. So those who are in and the digital content industry, you must have seen that a lot of people now they are fed up looking into a digital content. They have that there is no
getting echo
on the digital platform.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So this. Yeah, can you hear me? The rise of this industry, the digital content industry. So those who are in and the digital content industry. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Digital content. Yeah. Okay. So the thing is, digital content industry will boom now.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, there is a very thin gap because people will start selling this content. Those who are content curator, they will start minting money, and this rise you can see immediately after 1.5 years down the line, because there will be a lot of companies will come into a digital content market, and they will start growing and growing and growing and growing. So this is how it will be.
Great.
So these are the major industry which I see now, and it will definitely grow.
Okay.
Events, and you can see events and all, it will have a slack because there will be a lot of restriction on events.
Yeah.
But gradually, slowly, steadily, after the month of September, October, November, might be events industry will start again. See the sector again in a very good limelight is education industry. So education and skills will be again into a booming side, because if you must have seen this whole lockdown, people are actually trying to acquire a lot of knowledge and skills. So they will also now migrate themselves. Some will migrate to go on a higher stage. Some will migrate to another level. So definitely the skills and the education industry will also move up.
Mm-hmm.
So these are my takes on it.
So there's a question from Venkatraman Iyer about the real estate. Lodha says they have done 300 bookings in lockdown. What is your view on this?
See, it's a very controversial thing. There is no proof. There is no sign of proof. There will be a pre-booking sign.
Yeah.
People are actually looking to actually manipulate. Unless and until if there is no proofs to be shown, you cannot rely on those news.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you must have seen in marketing, people goes to any level of manipulation, and you cannot figure it out. Because I have a very good friend in Lodha. He's into recovery department.
Mm-hmm.
It's becoming very difficult to recover funds before the lockdown. So how it is possible to get a 300
lockdown
booking
time,
in time period? It is next to impossible to believe this.
Yes, yes.
But I think that people should not go on these talks. Rather, some factual things in the industry. Those, if they have a good connect insights inside the industry, they should check and verify with them. So that's why I tell you, re-evaluate. Because you know, there is a very old saying, "Dunya jhukti hai, jhukane wala chahiye."
Yes.
So this industries, those who are downfalling industries, which they have already diagnosed by some research work.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever I have told today, it's actually a research which has come from KPMG. And I strongly believe on the researches of KPMG and Frost and Civilian.
Okay.
I follow this too. They have a lot of good insights on the research. They actually work on the insights on research. Yeah. So okay. My take is very clear. Before hearing those news,
yeah,
try to check, verify, reevaluate. So that is why I have that rediscover, redefine, reevaluate, reimagine. Is it practical? Is it really sounding you serious? If it is not, then please don't believe on those news and don't park your money there.
Yes.
Because you will require a lot of funds in a lot of rotation things. Or you can say a lot of people, capital has been moved into working capital now.
Yeah.
So it is very difficult to say what will coming next.
So you got a lot of questions coming in. Revant is asking about collaboration post lockdown with the real estate guys so he can get more business. And there's Nitin Nerulkar asking for automotive industries. There's a question from Mayan Sukija. Do you think office property rates will fall down due to work from home culture coming up successfully? And Mohit Rawal says, please share a view and idea for travel industry and holidays planning agency.
So can we take one by one?
Yeah, so Revant.
So Revant, collaboration with real estate, yes, it is. Because you have to figure out which real estate, definitely you should collaborate. But if it is a very big players, I feel not. Because big players will have a very tough time because they have lot of issue in fund rotation. Small players, they will survive because they have not overtrade into that. They have worked with their limitations.
Yeah.
So automatically the small players will fetch you a lot of collaboration and a lot of benefits there.
Yes.
So we can take to the next regarding the property from Mahin Sukija because I will tell you, property will never fall. Because that is the only so when you go and buy, you will always land up buying little higher. But naturally, when you want to sell, it will always if it is a distress sale, then it is a loss.
Yeah.
If it is not a distress sale and you can hold on the property in the commercial areas, sell the property. At least for a 2020 end, you should hold it and then only you should sell the property because property is a very key subject for a lot of investment. Yeah.
So and there was a question about automotive industries. Nitin Nerulkar was asking.
See, automotive industry, if you will tie up with a brand called Maruti and their auto components, stuff, yeah, they will survive because Maruti is always a brand of survival. But if you will collaborate or if you will see the automotive industry in the premium segment or a supercar already started falling down and they have already started getting a troublesome. Yesterday I was seeing an article on Google which was amazing rates of second pre-owned cars, so it was very difficult to digest that news. So I'm not understanding why those type of news has been manipulated and been created. It is not possible to digest because if you can imagine the premium segment car was already suffering and they were trying to show a grace up in the month of Feb and March, but that has not been followed down. But if there is a if statement here, because there are a lot of people who have still not actually filed their returns, so there might be a some small phase where people might buy auto, but after that it will be a little difficult to sell because gradually the want based.
I'm losing you.
So now, yeah, you can hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Okay, so there was a question on health and fitness industry, a wellness industry from Suresh. I mean, that you shared it, it's going to go high for sure. And there's a question from Ketan Mehta. Jigarbhai, please share your thoughts on e-commerce.
Yeah, see the e-commerce, if you will see Facebook coming in with Jio.
Yes.
This is the biggest statement for India and China too.
Yes.
Because this shows that, you know, they want to company.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have seen, as I told in my past, right now that I was the expertise in segment marketing.
Mm-hmm.
So what Jio is doing, Jio Mart and Facebook, they are coming with Jio Lazo. So Jio Lazo checked where city stores. So they have more than 300 billion users.
Wow.
You can imagine TikTok has 2.4 billion users, mm-hmm. active users. Mm-hmm. This is the game. This is the war now in the online market. So there will be lot of players in this post lockdown, and during lockdown, it was a big hit from Jio. And this shows there will be also a trade war, because okay. when you see a Facebook taking 10%, which is 9.19% mm-hmm. stake in Jio, so it is like, you know, it is someone. Facebook is the big giant in the online segment, and why they're taking up, because they will be merging WhatsApp as and a Jio Mart together, and they'll mm-hmm. come up with a product called Jio Lazo.
Wow.
And this product will be actually catering to 300 million user of small and medium grocery shops. Can mm-hmm. you imagine the online payment gateway market will be so big? You can yeah. imagine the revenue, what amount of revenue will be transacted every day online. Mm-hmm. So that online is a new, and it will boom. It will boom like anything. And if you are actually, Ketan Bhai, if you have funds to invest, we have actually started this during this lockdown, tied up with one of the best associate partner called Manoj Danwani, who is an e-commerce mm-hmm. specialist. And he is now actually partnering with us as his company name is Snell Business Consulting. And we both are partnering into an e-commerce based clientele because he has his expertise over a decade now to cater online businesses.
Mm-hmm.
So why we have started this, because you can see Jio and Facebook collaborating. So big funds coming into an online segment, there'll be a lot of other people will be investing more or pumping money online platform. The scarcity of consultants,
yeah,
online platform. So this is where me and Manoj, we sat and we decided we should start something on the online stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And online will be the new green, because if you have not yet started something on online, become an investor online, then I will say it's go getter situation. If you will not get up today, tomorrow it will be too late to come into an online market, because there'll be loads and loads of players will be entering into this market.
Mm-hmm.
And it will go strategically. It will not boom immediately. You will not see the reflection of ROI very fast. But yes, it will, because when you see over a period of time, people are moving from a small grocery stop on a WhatsApp payment gateway.
Yeah.
Can you imagine what type of payment gateway will be open for a lot of other areas of shopkeepers? People focus on that. It will be great. It will be great.
Great. So Ketan is messaging you, I had a very good project that I can share and work together. So tomorrow you should be in touch with Ketan Mehta.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
Harsh Kami is saying, I guess you believe wellness will do better, but wellness doesn't come cheap. So how do you feel this market should be capitalized?
Yeah, I agree. Anything which is booming, it doesn't come. But the people now, they are very well aware of organic, mm-hmm. sattvic.
Mm-hmm.
So what I've seen in this lockdown, what I'm seeing, people are actually moving toward the wellness of organic products.
Mm-hmm.
So organic comes in a very cheap investment, in a very small term investment. So if you want to capitalize on that, you can start with some products on wellness on organic platform, because organic will be the new green. And it has a very big export market too. Mm-hmm. But if you can imagine a Facebook investing in India, so it's a basically a trade war. So automatically, China never believes in organic stuff. Yeah. They believe in their speciality, their culture, organic, their authenticate Chinese organic stuff. But India is also very enriched in terms of a lot of organic foods, organic methods of farming. And I think, Harsh, I will connect you with my friend called Parth. He is also have learned a lot of stuff on organic farming. When I met him and I was understanding, because those days we don't have that much time to worry upon the timing. So I was sharing a lot of insight with this friend of mine. And Parth has actually explored lot of stuff in organic thing. And he has studied this in some of the university in Rajasthan. And what I've also, after that, what I've also researched on organic products, it has a very big market from India. Very big market from India. Yeah, Bharat. You have a lot of questions, Bharat.
Yeah, so Mohit is saying you missed holiday planning agency. Please share how we travel agents should take it further post-lockdown open.
Sorry, I didn't got you.
Mohit Rawal is into holiday planning agents. He's a travel agent, I think. So how should he take it further post-lockdown open? Because travel is one industry which is very...
Actually, I'm so sorry, Rohit. Mohit.
Mohit, yeah.
I'm actually very sorry to tell you, but it will pick up. But I will tell you what you need to do is you need to start a holiday planning for India tourism.
Yes.
And those people who are willing to come from abroad to India in different part of Kerala and a lot of state. Yeah. Because that will get a big revenue in Indian market too.
Mm-hmm.
It will take, I think so, post lockdown 90 days, a tough time for your industry.
Yeah.
But yeah, it will settle down. And as the as if you must have heard, the New Zealand has given a green clearance now from COVID-19.
Mm-hmm.
So the people from the tourism industry will have a now straight away hit to the New Zealand tourism market.
Okay.
And it is a very beautiful place to be. And yeah, it has a very, very heavy packages also.
Yeah.
So you can figure it out in that way. Or otherwise, I don't feel there is a great market for you. So there is only two take for you. One is the Indian tourism and one is the other countries where there is a green sign from the government of those countries.
And Shruti is a garment retailer. She's saying, how should we tackle the upcoming economical crisis in retail industry?
If few industry is also supposed to be going down, because people will only buy once it is a need, and it will become on the last priority as the garments when we see the list. Mm-hmm. Of priorities in the need base also there will be a lot of priorities.
Mm-hmm.
So when you see some priority in terms of garments, it will take some time, but yeah, it will have a survival market at least. It will not get completely closed down or something like that, because garment is also a survival product.
Yeah.
So it will not have any issues in don't feel. But it will take some time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Karan Soni says they will use WhatsApp Business at its best. There's many features for online digital business. And
yeah, great, Karan.
Revan says, Jigar, now let's connect on the lighter side. Tell us something about the daily routine.
Oh, that's great. So my daily routine is... So I wake up and I do a lot of research. So that is my main key to success still today. Mm-hmm. So when I do research, I have a typical method of doing it. So that is what I do. And then I actually did some daily work from 11 to 1-ish. And that time I make my kids also study with me. And then 1, 2, 3, we are free, we are enjoying, and we are having food and all that stuff. And then 3 to 5, I do activity with my kids. So mm-hmm. might be someday we do some craft, seeing some YouTube channel. Someday we do some drawing. Someday we do some type of storytelling. Someday we watch some good cartoon movies and all that stuff. And after 5 to around 7, I go for a walk, because I've also now gone on a sattvic diet, as well as I've started walking a lot. So I've committed to myself that I will at least walk 10,000 to where, and which I am achieving. Today also I have walked around 10,000 plus steps, and I'm really finding very lighter in body, a lot of energy, a lot of positivity in my mind, and it is giving me a boom. Like, you know, as always Revan say, boom.
Yeah.
So that's the call on this thing, Revan.
Okay, Amita Chokshi says, Jigar, right now the whole world will prefer India for vacation.
Yeah.
Hetal is saying, so many realistic insights in various fields. Kudos to you.
Thank you, Hetal.
Daksha Shah is showing some of the GIF that you are excellent.
Oh, Daksha Shah is my mom.
Okay.
Every day I just always try to tell her, like, you know, you are my dearest.
Yeah. And Mohit Rawal says, thanks. Yes, I agree. Domestic market will boom, and for sure it will take 90 or days or few months to start. As before, hope for the best and best wishes to all. So, Jigar, huge. I mean, so many questions. I don't know whether I missed out or not, one or two questions, but we are at, I mean, this talk has gone to a long time, almost 50 minutes now.
Yeah.
What is one message will you give it to business owners and entrepreneurs on the post-lockdown part? One message.
That is very simple, Bharat.
Yeah.
You must have observed, we Indians are so good in conservative living.
Yeah.
We Indians are actually very practical in terms of finance when it comes to finance.
Yes.
When it comes to party, we also, if you see, we are the absorbers, you know. Yeah. We absorb lot of new things, lot of new technology, lot of new taxation shift, you can say, what do you call this, demonetizing.
Mm-hmm.
So if you, we Indians are actually suffering in business, Indian business environment.
And yeah.
Actually, people were very happy in 2020 that, you know, now things are actually getting little bit sorted.
Yes.
And this COVID pandemic hit it. And then we started a blame game and whatever. But I feel it is the negative is the new positive. That is the biggest message mm-hmm. to all of us. We need to open our eyes now. We need to work on a lot of 90 days planning, because we are meant to be absorbers. We have absorbed so many shifts in our life, so many transformation in our life.
Mm.
We have absorbed technology transformation. We have absorbed so many things.
Yeah.
So this will also go. This will also move off. And why negative is a new positive? Because if somebody, if you hear in your dear ones that he has been positive on COVID, we always say to ourselves, "Oh my God, he should be negative,
mm-hmm.
not positive on COVID." So that is the sign which hits me that, you know, that negative is the new positive.
Mm-hmm.
And I will suggest that a good message to all the people who are listening today or seeing the interview. Just follow the 90 days plan. So yeah. Redefine some stuff, reevaluate, reimagine, and start redefining in terms of 1 week plan.
Yes.
Because if you do 1 week plan, you will be able to move your shifts to the another level.
Yeah.
So first week, if you feel that there is a lot of cash crunches, crisis coming up, just focus on your deliverables which are pending. Just mm-hmm. focus on what are the people who have already promised you during the lockdown that, you know, they want your services and they want your those people, start connecting with them into a logical way, into not an a bombarding way, yeah, or a kind of annoying marketing way, so that you can start regenerating your business slowly, steadily, and then you can have a growth on that side, mm-hmm, of it automatically. So 90 days plan, but in 90 days plan, you need to go weekly and weekly, reevaluate everything after every week, so that you are into a redefining part every day, every week after week. And that way your 90 days will get over. You will come into a shape and everything from negative to the new positive will automatically start. It will not get, clubbed up with a lot of stuff.
Great.
So this is my message to everyone.
And I always remember you saying skill way or will way.
Yeah, that is the thing, because right now you have heard a lot of skills in terms of insights, in terms of a lot of stuff from the different industry part. But now it is your will. If your will is not allowing you to do, then you will never ever able to follow that.
Yeah.
Even though wherever I go and do consultancy, I always go on a weekly basis.
Yes.
Like every week I make sure that, whatever strategy we have applied from the last week to this week, is it getting me some results?
Okay.
And if it is getting me some results, then we are on the right track. So we have actually wasted a week if we are not on the right track. And if we are on a right track, and we need to invest one more week. So week after week, you will be able to join it. So it is like, if you know the skill, you need to have a will to acquire it.
Mm.
So it is always a skill or a will. Okay. So if both comes together, then you are unstoppable, boss. Nobody can stop you to grow.
So there's one more question from Harshal about digital content industry. Yeah. What do you feel future of OTT business segment or industry performance?
Definitely. If you understand, there are a lot of platforms coming up. Like I was hearing from one of my friends about one platform called Ulu or Lulu. I forgot the name.
Ulu. Yeah, Ulu.
And they have a lot of censored-based thing on their platform.
Mm-hmm.
But, they have actually targeted to a very low segment, demographic segment.
Yeah.
Into an income side.
Mm.
And they have most of the active users today than the other platform, because other platform is on the higher side in terms of revenue,
mm-hmm,
and they have other market to compete.
Yeah.
In that low segment. So you can imagine this Lulu app was not going so great, but now they are actually ranking themselves in top three.
Wow. Nice.
So how is this possible? So they have actually segmented well. So everything is the key to success is segment. And they have actually done a lot of product gap analysis.
Mm-hmm.
And when you do those gap analysis, you automatically reach to some conclusion, some points. Yeah, this is the thing. And this is the thing you need to hit it back to the audiences.
Yeah.
Right. So when you start hitting it back, automatically you gain the market.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the...
Great. And Himangi says, thanks a lot, Jigar. You are so articulate and have such a calm demeanor and loved all the workable tips and insights. We'll definitely get to work on many of these.
Thank you, Himangi.
Manoj says, amazing, Jigar. And Tejal Fatke says, great, Jigar. Amazing shares and very practical. So
thank you, Tejal.
A great talk by you, Jigar. And I think a lot of our audience got a great positive insights on what's next after the lockdown, what's next after COVID-19, how are you going to look at a bright future. So that's a way you encourage a lot of business owners and entrepreneurs to grow, and that's the best way to look at business coach or management consultant. Do it, be positive, and negative is new positive. That's what you say. It's actually a new positive. So anytime when we have happiness, we don't measure it. But then we have some sad moments, we measure it. So the sad moments are going off and happiness will come in India for sure. And people vouch for your services, Jigar. And they will also look for it.
And
before signing off, can I add a small story about
happiness? Yes, and yes, sure.
So there was a two guys. So one was a very healthy, very tough, and very, very, very difficult guy. You know, you cannot beat that guy.
Yeah.
And one was very thin, very small, and very little guy. So this both of were coming on one bicycle. They were riding together. So the healthy and tough guy name was Sadness.
Mm-hmm.
And the very thin guy, the name was Happiness. Mm-hmm. So Happiness was sitting behind Sadness. So they were coming in the cycle. So if you can imagine that cycle coming towards you. So if you feel that Sadness is coming you, but don't forget the Happiness is always sitting behind the Sadness.
Yeah, that's great.
And
yeah,
that is the only key to success.
Yes.
So keep faith in Almighty. I always believe that there is a power, yeah, there is some Almighty power which drives us every day.
Yes.
So keep faith on Him. This negative situation is already half the way. And we are actually coming to an end of this negative situation. But this negative situation, make the most of it. Make your most connection. Be unstoppable during this negative situation. So automatically, you will be so much good, positive vibes. You will come, get in. You will get more connection. You'll get more insights about your product, your services. And start growing towards it. That's so post-lockdown, you'll have some strategy in your hand to move further. Some contacts, some new connections to move further. And that will fetch us the great, great, great going after the lockdown.
Nice. So Dispal Sakaria says, Jigar's approach is very practical. Sandeep Dixit says, great tips, Jigar. And Suresh Notani says, growth is on, Jigar.
Yeah, thanks, Suresh, because this is my tagline. And some of my business colleagues, they always keep on teasing me. Whenever I come and stand or I shake hands with them and I talk to them, hey Jigar, growth is on.
Growth is on.
that is my company's tagline. I feel very proud to tell people when your morning starts and your eyes open, you have to realize what growth is on. You need to work towards your growth, because nobody will come and catch your hand and show you the growth. You have to work towards it. So I always say growth is on. You can always get that growth. Any given day, any given time.
So this video will be on SV Live for sure, and it will be on YouTube channel Ascent to Central India. If anyone wants to reach out to Jigar, they can reach out tomorrow. If anyone wants to go through me, let me know. I can connect you with Jigar. Jigar, thank you for your patience and a great talk. We will have tomorrow Dr. Onkar. He's an Ayurvedic doctor and works with a lot of sports personalities on immunity and better nutrition. So tomorrow, 9 p.m. FP Live, Dr. Onkar with us, who's going to talk about immunity also in this COVID-19 time, which can help you to be away from coronavirus and have a better, safe, healthy life. Whoa. So thank you, Jigar. We are at the end of the talk. Manoj Dharma says, well said, bro. And there's a party from Manoj to you. Harshal Dalal, thank you. And the bakers are ready to give you cake later post-lockdown, but it was a wonderful talk and one of the lengthiest talk. It's almost 1 hour. So many comments coming up. And I don't know if I missed out any of the comments, please apologize. Sorry, because I must have missed out in the sequence, and you can reach out to us anytime. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, guys. Thank you. Thank you for your love and your support. Thank you. And all the best post lockdown. And negative is the new positive. Thank you.
Okay, we are off Facebook.
Okay.
Wow.
So we are off. Oh, thanks.
We got a huge, huge fan following. I mean.